Stuart Valentine is going to be talking about community capital, creating that. Joel Hadrock, where's Joel?
So Stuart's actually asked me to come back next month and co-present with him. He just asked me on the drive down. Two things. My colleagues Clyde and Brad. They're on the board of the Twin Cities Eco Village Meetup Group. So we've got over 100 people in a discussion about founding an Eco Village, and they're helping to lead that. So after we visit your Eco Village, we're crossing the border into Missouri and visiting Dancing Rabbit. So the other thing that I've been working on for quite a while is, what's the next generation of money? We've seen cryptocurrency, a big speculative bubble of baloney that's not bringing any communities out of poverty and not creating jobs. And we say, let's try something different. Instead of mining, which is just a computer algorithm and doesn't add a lot of social value, instead of the dollar, which is doing fine in some ways, terrible in others, but once backed by gold, now backed by debt, and the government's promised to issue more money if there's a problem with the money. That's a little strange, but what if we actually stretch the dollar to where it isn't getting the job done, and instead of backing it with gold or debt or computer algorithms, what if we backed it with the currently wasted wealth of society? Empty college desks, empty airline seats, off hours at the movies, the YWCA, the oil chain shops. The funny thing about our modern society is that everything we know, and I'll wrap it up quick. Everything we know about money, economics, and commerce was inherited from an era of scarcity, which drove win-lose competition over money and a grow-or-die business imperative. Well, today, food's an abundant renewable resource and people still go hungry. Digital stuff is infinite and downloadable. We have more classes than anyone could consume. We have more movies, more magazines, more newspapers, more of everything pretty much, other than maybe Rolls Royces and mountain villas. But the problem in the global economy isn't that everybody isn't getting their Rolls Royce and their mountain villa, right? It's that the basic needs of even billions of people aren't being met when the stuff is out there and all that's missing is money. And I want to tell you right now, it isn't the rich having all the money in their accounts, because it's not about a number in a computer. It's about moving the stuff that's abundantly available where it's needed. And there isn't a rich family on the planet that can eat enough food to cause anyone to go hungry, live in a big enough house to cause anyone to be homeless, consume enough education or health care for anybody to go without. So what's exciting about this work we're doing is it's beyond left versus right. And how it works is, we contract with merchants on a dual currency basis, so there's enough cash in the deal so they make money, and enough new money in the deal so that the consumer saves money and society has a social currency, not just the old-fashioned dollar. And this model, so what that looks like is a $20 restaurant meal might be 12 cash and 8 new money. Let's call it community service dollars for now. So the 12 means, just like 2-for-1 dining or senior discounts or student discounts or happy hour, that the merchant's making a cash profit. The new money saves the consumer money, and at the end of the day, instead of just a throwaway coupon or less cash, we actually have this new community currency to raise the quality of life across the board. So money backed by real goods and services issued for what? Well, today we issue money for consumer spending. We call it loyalty rewards, but it's business money backed by business excess capacity, and it's thousands of competing currencies, right? Everybody wants you to bring the currency back to them. But the idea of backing money with excess capacity is a neat idea. Again, lots of capacity, food, school, restaurant meals, beauty shops are empty a lot of the time. All right, so contracting with merchants on a dual currency basis stretches cash and creates a next generation currency. And why is this imminently possible? Because in this day and age, just think about this, the sharing economy scaled in just a few years to millions of jobs and billions of dollars in new wealth. Now, did we all get richer because of that? No, because it was coming in through win-lose competition over money, right? So hotels, motels, and their employees took the hit. Cab drivers, limo drivers, and their companies took the hit. So this is a money based on the possibility of win-win cooperation. If some of you are TM community members. It was what Maharishi once called politics and economics in harmony with all the laws of nature. Right? Nature cooperates. Nature, you know, just is nature. So we've had really weird economics inherited from an era of scarcity, and the scarcity's not there, but the economics still reflects that. So that's just a peek. And I'll go much slower when I share the stage.
Oh, no, this is great. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So Thursday, June 28th.